or introducing people to a culture in an organization feels enormous. In many ways, it is enormous. I've seen companies try to standardize it, you know, with materials, which I think is okay. You know, what's our culture about and mission statements. But I do think that, like any human endeavor, the way we become acculturated into an environment is A, it's over time. B, it's via social modeling. So we have to see other people and what they're doing and what the consequences are in order for us to learn what works here and what doesn't. And a lot of that is the culture. And when I say what works and what doesn't, it's everything from, do we eat lunch together? Do we not eat lunch together? Do we dress casual? Do we not dress casual? You know, dedication to excellence beyond, you know, from my opinion, with when a culture, you know, dedication to excellence, that's a stupid cultural norm. And the reason I say that is every company should be dedicated to excellence. Like that doesn't help. And so I do think that if, you know, to our emailer, you don't have to become overwhelmed that you need an endless supply, endless amount of resources, financial and people resources to create strategy and culture. What you do have to do as a small business owner or smaller is you still have to pay attention to how are people interacting with one another? What are the words that are said? What do the interactions look like and how are people performing? How does that match up with what, you know, if it's small enough, what you have in your head, and not brush that off of the to-do list?